All right, Coach. I know obviously not the way you wanted to end the season, but a lot of teams would have loved to have even gotten this far. Just your thoughts?
Well, you know, I thought, you know, we played extremely hard. Dallas Center Grahams is a very, very good ball club. You know, they came out on fire there, especially in that first quarter, and really built a lead. And, you know, it's hard to come back against the number three team in state when, you know, they're hitting that many threes in the first half. But, you know, I'm proud of the way our boys, you know, battled. I think we were down 14 at one point, battled back down to six. And we just couldn't make enough plays there. And when Skyler and Dayton both fouled out, you know, we knew it was going to be tough offensively for us. But, you know, we're not going to hang our heads. I mean, we had a phenomenal year, co-conference championship. And, you know, these guys had going from 3-5 to 14-7 having a shot. That says a lot about their character and their work ethic.
Seemed like they weren't going to miss early on. How much did that maybe deviate from what you guys wanted to do?
Actually, it was more of us over-helping on some things where our scouting report says, hey, we can't give them that much room. And, you know, sometimes, you know, you got packed house, you know, big game, things like that. Sometimes guys lose focus a little bit, and we did. And you got to give Dallas Center Grahams credit. Houston really made us pay there early, and they all did in that first half. I think they hit six threes in that first half, if I was correct, or somewhere around there. And, you know, that's hard to overcome. And, you know, I got to give Coach Rankin credit. Fourth quarter, I noticed he decided to kind of stall the ball out there a little bit because obviously we played pretty well in the fourth quarter as games lately, so. He kind of took the ball away from us, and you know, you gotta give them credit. They're well coached, and you know, they're gonna hope, yeah, they might make some noise there next week in the state tournament.
When you look back on this game, if you had a do-over, what would it be?
I'll shoot the ball better a little bit. We just we had our moments shooting the ball. I think sometimes, you know, we just got to kind of simplify things, and you know, some guys kind of over dribbled here and there, you know, things like that. But you know, that happens. That's basketball. And you know, we're going to keep our heads high, and we know that the seniors that we're losing, they set the bar even higher than it was the previous 2 years. We're gradually bringing that up, so the underclassmen got a lot to live up to, and, you know, we'll get back to work, and hopefully next year, you know, keep improving.
Heck of a year for you guys. You mentioned the strong finish, sharing the Hawkeye 10 title with Glenwood, avenging two losses to Glenwood. When you look back on this year, what's going to be the one thing that sticks out the most?
Just the attention to detail and the work ethic of our guys. They put a lot of time in, a lot of film work, a lot of scouting reports. And, that, you know, that's stuff that people don't notice. You know, you can think about the wins and losses and all that, but just being around the guys, it's going to be hard not being in the gym tomorrow without them. I mean, we had 56 practices this year, and it's just going to be weird not seeing their faces in that gym. So, you know, like I said, I'm proud of them. And, you know, next year we'll see what happens and we'll see what we can do.